हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज विनोद कुलकर्णी, लेक्चरर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सीएसएनडी, जैन पॉलिटेक्निक, बेलगावी। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द यूनिट 6, फाइल सिस्टम कंटेंट्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी फाइल कंसेप्ट, फाइल एट्रीब्यूट्स, फाइल ऑपरेशंस, एक्सेस मेथड्स। सो फाइल कंसेप्ट मीन्स वी विल सी द डेफिनेशन ऑफ फाइल। सो फाइल इज ए नेम्ड कलेक्शन ऑफ रिलेटेड इन्फॉर्मेशन रिकॉर्डेड ऑन सेकेंडरी स्टोरेज लाइक योर डिस्क, सीडीज, हार्ड ड्राइव्स। ओके, so the types of files are text file, source file, object file and executable file. So the text file means it contains a sequence of characters organized into the lines. Source file contains a sequence of subroutines and functions. Object file contains sequence of bytes organized into the blocks which are understandable by the system's linker. Executable file contains series of code sections that the loader can bring into memory and execute. So the attributes of file, attributes means the characteristics which define the file. Okay, so the attributes are name, identifier, type, location, size, protection, time, date and user identification. So the name indicates symbolic file name, which is the only information kept in human readable form. So whenever you create a file with any name, it is understandable by saying that what it contains. Identifier is a unique tag or a number which identifies file within the file system. The type of the file contains the information which is needed to support different types of file. Location means where it contains a pointer to a device and to the location of the file with acting on that device. Size, the size of the file is the current size of the file in bytes, words or blocks. Protection means it contains access control information which describes who can do reading, writing, executing and so on. Last point is it contains information which can be kept for creation, last modification and last use. It is useful for protection, security and usage monitoring. Next is file operations. So what all operations we can do on the file is creating a file, writing a file, reading a file, repositioning within a file, deleting a file, truncating a file. So creating a file contains two steps. First is we should allocate a space in the file system. And next, whenever the space is allocated, there should be an entry for a new file that must be needed in the directory. Writing a file, we are going to edit a file. So to write a file, we make a system call specifying both the name of the file and the information to be written within a file. Reading a file, we are accessing the information from the file. So to read a file, we need a system call that specifies the name of the file and where, means in the memory, the next block of the file to be put. Repositioning within a file means what? The directory is searched for the appropriate entry and the current file position pointer is repositioned to a value. It is also called file seek. It means that we are searching a file in the directory. Deleting a file means we are allocating a space for the other file to be present. Deleting this file. So delete a file, we search first directory for the named file. Once the directory is found, we search for the directory entry where the file is there. And once we have got the file, we delete the file, releasing the memory space for other files to allocate the space so that it can be reused for other files. Truncating a file means what? The user wants to erase the content but keep the attributes of the file. Means we can keep a blank file. Okay. Access methods. So these are different methods of accessing the file: sequential access, direct access, and other access. In sequential access, it is the simplest access method, in which the information in the file is processed in the order one record after the other. For example, editors and compilers usually access the files using this fashion. So if we want to do read operation, we make a system called read next. Using that, we can read the next position of the file and automatically advances the file pointer. As we are reading the next block of the file, the file pointer will also increase. Similarly, with the writing the file, we have the write next system call, in which we will append to the end of the file and advances to the end of the newly written material. As we are going to write the new blocks of the file, we are going to increase the pointer. Next comes direct access. It is also called relative access, in which the file is made of fixed length block that contains programs to read and write the records in no particular order. Now the difference between sequential access and direct access is that there is no particular order of accessing the information. Okay, so it is based on the disk model of a file. Here the file is viewed as a numbered sequence of blocks or records used for immediate access to large amounts of information. Now next is other access. Other access methods contain the index. So here it involves the construction of an index for the file. The index contains a pointer to various blocks. Whenever we have to find a record in the of the file, we will find the search for the particular index. Once the index is got, we need a pointer to access the file directory, and then we will find the desired record. Next comes file system mounting. Mounting means what? We are keeping a file on other file. Okay, so here file system can be mounted before availability of process to the system. Here operating system is given the name of the device and the mount point. Suppose there is a file system, we want to insert that file system in some other directory. So we have to take permission from the operating system which device we are going to insert, and in which device we are going to insert, and what is the mount point, what is the particular location we are going to insert that data. So the mount point is the location within the file structure where the file system is to be attached. So here, as we can see in the diagram, there is a root file which contains three structures, ABIN, etc, opt. Again, ABT contains, ABT file, ABIN file system contains three files, mount, RC0, shutdown, and etc file system contains other different file systems, FS and opt. Again, FS contains UFS, UFS contains the file mount. In etc file system, it contains the files group, system and TTY, DFS. Again, opt file system contains Sunvico and unbundled. Again, unbundled contains two different file systems, app1 and app2. App1 contains files, file1, file2, file3. Again, app2 contains file1, file2, file3. So, as it is shown in the mount point, the mount point is unbundled file system is file1, file2, file3. So, we are going to mount the unbundled file system under the opt file system. Okay, thank you.